Hello, I'm Mike with this week's AI tools you can't afford to miss, especially if you're vibe coding. ChatGPT just dropped O3 Pro. Yes, O3 Pro is now the best at reasoning model, but it does cost $200 a month. Let's give it a test. Now, my micro-SaaS is currently burning through not only credits on my ChatGPT API, but also my Amazon Simple Storage has really significantly gone up. So I really need to do something with this project, and I'm going to feed the code into O3 Pro. And the way I'm going to do this is actually use a tool I like to use all the time called UitHub. If I type UitHub there, it gives me a flat file of all my code here, which is brilliant for copying and pasting. Now, as O3 Pro has a bigger context window, I think up to 200,000 tokens, I can certainly fit in my under 50,000 tokens to the full context and give it a go. And I'm simply going to go ahead and ask it, here's my micro-SaaS project, give me a list of things I can do to improve user experience and come up with a simple pricing plan I can use to sell credits and how I should integrate it using Stripe MCP in Claude Code or Cursor. Okay, with that said and added to my context, let's grab the context here of the code and we'll simply enter, put in a few dashed lines to separate, and we'll paste all the code in and we'll set ChatGPT O3 Pro to work. Now you'll see when I do this, first of all, you can pop open details just as you could with O1 Pro and it sits there and reasons for a while. Now, in my experience, this has taken 10, 15, 20 minutes on other projects I've thrown at it. I've thrown in YouTube transcripts and other stuff to think about different ideas that I'm working on. So we'll leave that working away for a little while and come back to it later. If you're enjoying this week's update so far, do throw a like and subscribe. It really helps the channel to grow so I can deliver more great stuff for you. Okay, quick peek in here. Yes, that's right. It's investigating my micro-SaaS, optimizing the user flow, and even crafting a pricing strategy. Now we'll pair this with another tool I'm going to be using later in the video, so stick around for that. At this point, I'd like to show you Gemini 2.5 Pro Preview. Yes, I'm paying for the crazy Google AI Ultra $125 a month plan, but now they've rolled it out to their something like $20 a month plan Pro users. So that is really good. Whether you have Ultra or Pro, you can generate with VO3 right inside Gemini. And it's been a great way for me to generate these beautiful videos that I'm sharing on my Instagram.
I just finished my masterpiece in Midjourney.
Things like that and this.
Alexa, play some classical music.
So I'm having fun with this and I'm posting it up to my relatively new Instagram account. And what I've discovered during time is that actually these reels are getting significant hundreds or even thousands of views on them compared to the GPT-4o images that are just down in the, well, low double digits at the moment. So I'm having great fun growing Instagram with reels generated on automation with VO3. And if you haven't seen the video I published earlier in the week, definitely go and check that one out. Now, I slightly upgraded my stack that I mentioned earlier in the week to use Grok 3 and soon to be 3.5, as I found it has the best sense of humor. Let's actually generate something now using Gemini and VO3, and I'm going to prompt Grok. So I'd like you to do another one of those, but do it with a character along with Eve in the Garden of Eden, trying to convince Eve not to eat the apple because she can use ChatGPT instead. Okay, with that entered as a prompt, we'll have Grok think over this. And with that done, Grok has actually opened up a canvas. And look at this, I've got my Pixar animation scene in the Garden of Eden. We've got our consistent main character. Yes, I've been generating consistent characters in VO3. I'm going to copy this and I'm going to paste it over into Google Gemini here. And it is on video mode, which you'll see is generating with VO3. And you'll see that it can take 3 to 5 minutes. So again, we'll come back to this shortly and see what it comes up with. This week's video is brought to you by my community, where I'm teaching you how to automate your AI video empire with Instagram using the tech stack that I'm using, and I'm updating this as I go along. Click the link down below to join now for a limited time before we hit 350 members. That's Creator Magic Premium, and it's linked up down below. And by the way, not only have we got a very active community, there is my tutorial on automating videos with VO3, but we're also starting a Coffee with Mike session exclusively for community members, and you can submit your question for me to answer on this live stream every single Monday. Okay, look at this. My video's ready. Shall I play? Let's play.
Eve, skip the apple. ChatGPT knows it all.
Now, one thing you'll notice is you can generate two more videos today, so there is a limited amount of free videos in Gemini, but it's an extra add-on compared to having just Google Flow to work with. So I'm going to re-roll a couple more times, see what I come up with.
Eve, skip the apple. ChatGPT knows it all.
Eve, skip the apple. ChatGPT knows it all.
Okay, finally this week, let's talk about overpowered coding with an MCP server that's brand new and might be the only MCP server you need to code with. This is the Zen MCP server. It's only been around for a few days on GitHub, but already it's amassed 1.2K stars. And the power is it works with Claude Code, but also brings Gemini Pro, Flash 03, 03 Mini, and OpenRouter to get you the best model and to do some really advanced reasoning. For instance, we can see in this demo video, it's reasoning which UI to use, and it uses O3 to do that, and then it comes back and it has a chat back and forth with every single model needed to make the best decision. This is pretty cool, and you can see there is a quick start here to get it running in 5 minutes with Docker, so I'm going to do just that. If you haven't downloaded Docker, do so. It's an excellent app that helps you run a load of AI applications. And first of all, I'm going to clone the repo over here. With that done, I simply run the setup Docker commands, and it should go away and create everything that's needed. Okay, we can see in Docker here on my Mac the Zen MCP server seems to be running, and it's doing the last bit of setup here. Okay, that all seems to be done, so now I'm going to edit the environment file, and this is where I'll go ahead and put in all of my custom API keys, which you'll be able to see are just listed along here in the README. Okay, with everything set up, I should be able to run this command, and yes, I can see here that the server Zen has been added with this Docker command. Great news! Now I should be able to Claude MCP list and check that it's there. Yes, Zen is indeed active in my Claude code. Let's have some fun working on Pimp My Thumb with this. Just in case you wondered, Pimp My Thumb is my micro-SaaS that lets you transform your YouTube thumbnails. So for instance, I can go ahead and grab this thumbnail, go back to Pimp My Thumb, paste this in, it'll ask me to log in with my Google, and then once that's done, it will go into my library and it will start generating a brand new version of my thumbnail. Boom! Okay! Now by the way, over here in O3 Pro, I can see after just 13 minutes, it's come together and given me a comprehensive plan on what to do with my UX, and also a bit of a pricing plan here as well for my micro-SaaS. This is great, it even gives me some code to integrate, so let's get started with the next steps that O3 Pro suggests. Okay, you'll see over here in Cursor, I've got Pimp My Thumb loaded up and I've got the terminal open so I can chat with Claude. Let's just type Claude in my project and I'm in Claude code. Now I can say use Zen and chat to find improvements for the look of my web app. And we'll run that and it's going to think away and then it's going to call, hopefully, on the Zen MCP. It says, I'll help you. It's calling the MCP model and it's actually calling Gemini Pro. And look at this. It's having a chat with Gemini Pro, which is looking over my code base. Okay, it's rolling through tokens now and it seems to have come up with some answers here. It says, based on the analysis, here are some ideas. Visual style selector, and we can make that more modern. Two column homepage layout. This is cool. Enhanced processing feedback, glass morphism effects. I love this. And improved typography hierarchy. It says, which area would you like me to implement first? I'm just going to say use Zen to do it all. And we'll see what it calls on now. It is indeed meditating over my request. It says, I'll use Zen. It's made a to-do list already of everything it's got to do. This is pretty interesting. It's called on Gemini Pro again. Okay, now it's finding all my files and it's got an understanding of the code base, so it's going to go ahead and implement all the changes. I'm running this all in YOLO mode, so it's just going through and doing everything for me as I've switched on auto accept edits. And we can see those edits are getting applied in real time over here to my code base. Okay, look at that. It says it's ticked off the whole to-do list here. And it says it's made some key visual enhancements, so I feel it's good. I'm not even going to check it. I'm going to do a commit message, send it up to my repo, and then deploy it. This is quite a fun new look with a live preview over here and glassy cards, but I've got to say, it won't let me generate thumbnails. And when I go to my library, my thumbnails are still there, thankfully, but I can't seem to do much. Oh, yeah, they do load up like that. But this homepage is now broken, so Claude Code was working with Zen to make it better, and it came up with some interesting ideas, although I don't like the way this spills off the end of the page now. It doesn't work, so bear in mind, it's pretty good to back things up and I'm glad I did. I'll roll back now. Okay, this is good news. Everything's working again. Let's go for a silly and fun thumbnail. We'll submit it and yes, now it's working away. The day has been saved. And here's that cool, fun version of my thumbnail. That looks really cool. Okay, so we'll get back to cursor, we'll go to settings, and we'll look at tools and integrations and add a custom MCP. So first I need to sign into my Stripe account, and I've created a brand new account here for Pimp My Thumb. Now I've already gone ahead and verified my business, added the bank. It's very important to select these are electronically supplied services, so the correct tax is applied worldwide. Okay, with this all set up and my initial verification done, I can get my secret key over here. Then we'll go over here to MCP JSON inside cursor and paste in the Stripe MCP server, just making sure to put my Stripe secret key right here. And you see the light has gone green and I've listed all the tools, plenty of stuff here. So essentially now I can add payment to my site and it should be pretty easy. Now, rather than O3's suggestion, I'm actually going to use this suggestion from Mark Liu directly on X. He suggested popcorn pricing, and here's the idea, of course, $3, $5, $6, so we can do this for credits. So I'm just going to copy this and use this as part of my prompt. Now, for this, I'm going to switch on max mode and go to Claude 4 Sonnet, and then I'm going to paste in use the popcorn pricing. I want you to add a new pricing modal that pops up when people click on their credits, and use Stripe to make these products. Also use Superbase to make an area in my Pimp My Thumb database to store all the information for paying users, please. There we go, that should be a pretty decent prompt. Let's let it run. Okay, so already Max Mode is thinking this through and helping to implement this with Stripe and also Superbase at the same time. It's a fantastic use of two MCP servers working together, hopefully in harmony. And the first MCP has been called to list the projects and it's found Pimp My Thumb. Now it's looking for tables, which is good. And now it's doing my first call to Stripe to create a product. Now it's creating the price for these products. And already in its thoughts, it can see the product that it's created, all those products. And now it's going to create the database structure for tracking payments. Now it's applying a migration. It's adding Stripe to my requirements. Okay, you can see this is comprehensively working away, updating all of my files, including the library, to have the pop-up for payment. Now, while this is happening, we can see it created a credit transactions and a purchases table, in addition to my three other existing thumbnail jobs, user credits, and users tables. Plus, over here in Stripe, I can see in my product catalog, the MCP has created a 50, 30, and 10 credits pack, which is great. It's also keeping me tax compliant by putting it in the right tax category. Now, as I'm a UK business, I can go in and set up the ability to continue the tax setup and collect VAT for UK and EU customers. So I'll set up United Kingdom and say I've already registered. I'll click no to the next question, start collecting VAT immediately. Thankfully, Stripe has automatic tax collection here, which is helpful. Now, in addition to collecting for the United Kingdom, I'll need to also register with an EU country, such as Ireland. I've already registered for that. And we're going to go for the Union One-Stop Shop. Again, collecting immediately. And now because we've got United Kingdom and Ireland, because of my geographic location, I'm completely tax compliant. Meanwhile, back over here in cursor, we can see, yes, we're ready to go. The system is fully functional. Users can click on credits, beautifully designed pricing modal, and purchase additional credits using Stripe Secure Payment. This is brilliant, and it'll all go into my database. Fantastic. Okay, let's see if I can upgrade by clicking 14 credits. And yes, indeed, I get a pricing plan for all the different packs we've got available. I could probably make this look tidier in the future. But for now, let's test with a 10 credit pack and see if correctly I get the yes, the address needs to be entered to calculate. Well, what better time to put in my card details and see if this actually works. And yes, it correctly identified that I need to pay that 20% VAT and I'm in the right location. So I can click pay. And look at that, my first payment has come through already on my Stripe dashboard of exactly £8.32 in British money. That is working. I'm pretty happy with what I've done so far. I've got the extra credits in my account, and now my SaaS is fully monetized. I think that's enough work for one day. Hopefully this has given you an insight into what is possible with vibe coding and MCP tools such as Stripe, Superbase, and even Zen for planning things out. Although I think I need to play with it more to figure it out entirely, but seems like a great new tool. Let me know how you're going to be using these tools. And remember, we continue the discussion in my community. It is linked up down below. And there is a free section if you want to just dip your toe in and have a look at what's going on. I encourage you to join over 12,000 of us building in the Creator Magic community. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen right now. You should watch next. Thanks.